Brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ be upon you. God has chosen the Jews as his people. Jews worshipped God in the temple but rejected Jesus, saying that he did miracles and cast the demons by Beelzebub and he has a devil. It is in Matthew 12:24 and John 8:48-52. Jesus called the Jews as the children of the devil. It is in John 8:43-44. God rejected them and destroyed their temple. Now, the servants of Satan, being mixed with Christians, call the supernatural manifestations of the Holy Spirit as the works of demons. In Mark 3:29, Jesus says, "He that shall blaspheme against the Holy Ghost hath no forgiveness, but is in danger of eternal damnation." Matthew 12:32, Jesus says, "Whosoever speaketh against the Holy Ghost, it shall not be forgiven him, neither in this world nor the world to come." That is, anyone who calls the manifestations of the Holy Spirit as the works of the devil will not be forgiven, and they will be condemned in eternal fire. Now let us see who begins the things of the Holy Ghost. Luke 3:16 says, "Jesus shall baptize you with the Holy Ghost." Jesus says in Mark 16:17, "Believers shall speak in new tongues." Here we see that the baptism of the Holy Ghost and the speaking in tongues are initiated by Jesus Christ. Let us see what he commanded, what Jesus commanded his disciples to do. Acts 1:4 says, "Jesus commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father." 5. "You shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence." 8. "You shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witnesses." That is, Jesus Christ requires them, or the disciples, or the followers, to be baptized by the Holy Ghost and then to preach his gospel. Those preachers who do not follow these commandments or instructions of Jesus Christ are preachers without license. Look at the following scriptures to verify whether the Holy Ghost baptism was manifested by the gifts of tongues or prophecy or by both. Acts 2:4. "They were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues and as the Spirit gave them utterance." Acts 10:44-46. "The Holy Ghost fell upon them all. The Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost, for they heard them speak with tongues." Acts 19:6. "The Holy Ghost came on them, and they spoke with tongues and prophesied." Acts 2:17. "In the last days, said God, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy." The last days that God mentioned are not over yet. We are still in the last days. So the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the gifts of tongues and prophecy is still being poured upon people. Recently, a man repeated my video on spiritual gifts with a video of John MacArthur. John MacArthur has 22 video clips against the gift of speaking in tongues. He is a famous leading pastor preacher from California. John MacArthur is a frequent guest to Larry King's show for many Christian issues, and he is a famous guy. In all his 22 video clips, he has called the works of the Holy Ghost as the works of the devil. I'm not able to rebuttal all his 22 videos here for lack of time, but I will pinpoint what he has said. If you want me to rebuttal any of his videos, write to me. Then I will rebuttal that video for you, comparing it with the Word of God. Let me compare here what MacArthur says with what the Bible says about Corinthian church. Let us see first what MacArthur has to say. He says, It is all his word, and what he said it, and I just going to repeat what he says. Point number one. Corinthians could no way have any gift of God at all, since they do not qualify to receive any gift from God. Two, Corinthian churches, Christianity and paganism welded together. Three, they let the entire mass of satanic system that existed in society infiltrate the church. Four, the spiritual gifts to Corinthians are from pagan god Diana. Five, the tongues in Corinthian church is the same as the tongue in the temple of Diana. Six, the pagan style religion where the priest and priestesses actually entered into orgies came to them. Seven, the whole idea of their sexual, sensual, erotic and gibberish that went on with divine utterances with tongues all rolled in one big ball under the mystery religion in Babylon has entered Corinthian church. These are just a few things from what John MacArthur has said. He blabbered a lot more things, which I don't have time to bring all the points here, but this is enough. Now, let us see what the Bible says about Corinthian church. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 4 to 7. I thank God, this is Paul writing, always on your behalf for the grace of God which is given you by Jesus Christ, that in everything you are enriched by him in all utterance and in all knowledge, even as the testimony of Christ was confirmed in you, so that you come behind in no gift, waiting for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. That is, the Bible says that God has given everything in full to Corinthian church, and they were waiting for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ as his bride. And a few that needed correction in the church were also corrected. In short, MacArthur says that the Corinthian church was under the pagan god Diana, and they perform orgies while speaking in tongues, whereas the Bible says that they are enriched by God in everything, and they are waiting for the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ as his bride. Which one is true? Why did John MacArthur slander God's church? The strange thing is that Christians considered this man as a great pastor and a leader. Is it not a shame to Christianity? So many preachers preach such things against the Holy Ghost manifestations. It is blasphemy. Knowing that blasphemy against the Holy Ghost is a sin which will not be forgiven, and they still do it. Why do they do it? 1 Corinthians 2 verse 14 says, the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can they know them, because they are spiritually discerned. That is, they blaspheme because they do not have the Spirit of God, and they think the manifestations of the Holy Spirit are foolishness. Let me talk to you. If you do not understand the manifestations of the Holy Spirit, it is because you do not have the Spirit of God. Romans 8:9 says, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. So, let me request you one thing. Will you ask God to give you the Spirit of Christ? Number two, will you ask Jesus Christ to baptize you with the Holy Ghost? Number three, will you ask the Holy Ghost to give you the gifts of the Holy Ghost? Those who ask with sincere heart will receive them. It is God's promise. God bless you. Thank you for listening.